quite an honor to present to you guys some really, really fun wine, a fun wine, and go back a little history. You know, my brother was the president of the Sons of the Desert Club in high school, where we watched old movies in his room as a young 9-10-year-old. He allowed me to do that, all the black and whites. And when I found out that, and I say, everybody says Bela Lugosi, don't they?
It's Bela.
It's Bela Lugosi. Right. Introduced the wine, Bela Lugosi. Did they call himself Junior?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So, but you're not really a junior, no?
No.
Yeah, okay. So, but Junior's here anyway.
Well, I am. You know, once the senior person deceased,
right.
Then...
You became Junior.
Then I don't have the Junior anymore. No, right. I did while he was alive.
Oh, I see. Yeah. Right. I get it now. But right. Your middle name is the same.
No middle name.
Oh, okay. So, so what the bottom line is, we have Bela Lugosi Jr. here, the son of Dracula. I don't think that's a movie, is it?
It is.
Oh, there is a movie, The Son of Dracula. And they've introduced a wine from Argentina, which is absolutely gorgeous. It's from the highlands of Argentina. And we're here to talk a little bit about old movies, and we're here to talk about winemaking. And the first question I have, I know that you are not in the film business.
No,
you are an attorney.
Yes, I am. I took my dad's good advice.
Oh,
he thought that on the talent side of the entertainment business, actors are too dependent upon producers and agents. And he thought that I should go into some profession. Sadly, he didn't live long enough to know that I actually...
That you made it?
That I made it, right.
Oh, boy. But you work for a firm, and you've got a couple of landmark cases that you've been involved with. One of them in the movie industry, right?
Oh, yes. Yeah, the landmark write a publicity case, which has to do with the ownership of the name and likeness for commercial purposes of deceased individuals.
Yes.
Yeah, that's my case, Lugosi versus Universal.
Wow, that's great stuff. And so, like, if I wanted to take this piece... and broadcast it all over the place. I don't have rights to this, do I?
Right, you have to have a license because it has his name.
But I know the guy. Junior, anyway, right?
You know Junior, yeah.
All right.
I'll make a special deal for you.
And you were a Trojan. I'm a Trojan. My wife's a Trojan. My kids are Trojan. My dad's a Trojan. He came here in 49 and graduated in 52. And you were there for...
Yeah. I was there. I graduated undergrad in 1960. And I was on the swimming and water polo teams.
Really?
And I graduated from law school in 64.
You know, they just honored at the SC game, the Washington game, the swimming and diving team from, was it 62? Was it national championship?
Yeah.
Wow, that's interesting. Are you swimming still or not much?
Not much.
Not as much as before.
Just in the ocean.
So here we have some fun things. Here's an old picture of Dad.
Yeah, that's Dad in his Dracula costume, his cape, and full dress.
Now, when he came to this country, what year?
In the early 20s.
From?
He's from Hungary.
Yes.
Yeah, from a town that's now in Romania. But he fled from Hungary, went into Germany, and got involved in the film business in Germany. Hopped a steamer bound for New Orleans. Got off the ship.
New Orleans. Wow, that's interesting.
Came to New York and then went through Ellis Island.
He went through Ellis Island.
Yes,
so you
did.
Track that through the documents?
Yes. I've been to Ellis Island where the historians have shown me all the records.
Wow, that's really exciting. Yeah. So he came here as an actor already, and did he feel, in the 50s, what was the last movie he made? What year?
He died in 56, right. So it was shortly,
He was still making movies at that point.
Yeah, he was still making movies.
So did he feel typecast at that point, or was he happy with that moniker that he got?
Well, he always used to say that it's a blessing and a curse.
Yeah,
and of course, it typecast him on the one hand, but it kept him employed, for those kind of parts.
Right, all the time. Yeah,
he was sad that he didn't have the ability to offer he was a very famous stage actor in Europe. And he couldn't bring all these other character parts to the screen.
Right, and it's sad actually, because he probably had some great things to do.
He's a very talented guy.
And I had to ask this question earlier, but did Boris Karloff hang around the house, or were you friends or?
Boris and Dad came from such different backgrounds. Boris drank tea and was from England and liked gardening.
Really?
So. Yeah, my dad liked food, music, cigars, good wine.
Now that's interesting.
His social friends were primarily people in the Hungarian community, artists, dancers.
And the Hungarian community in L.A. and Hollywood was
originally
prominent?
Well, there's a lot of people in the entertainment industry that are Hungarian.
Really, yeah. So.
Yeah.
Wow, that's interesting. So Boris did not hang around.
No.
No. But they were on screen about the same time, weren't they?
Yeah. Well, yes, and not only that, they were in movies together.
Oh, that's I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we have a lot of pictures of them together.
Well, I had a ton of fun looking for pieces of film to do this video with us, and you'll see the intro. Everybody's going to see the intro that I put together, but I had a lot of fun going through that because I remember the day sitting in my brother's room watching these old movies, and they would study them as a group, you know, and they had to write little papers on the things. So this is a 2007 Malbec. It's from the region of Argentina that's way up high, and it's like with the highest elevation in
yes,
the world,
it's
right,
for wine growing? It's from Salta, so it's on the eastern foot of the Andes. The vineyards go between where this wine came from 6,500 to 7,500 feet
that's
elevation.
That's amazing.
Yeah, and what happens is the mold doesn't grow because of the lack of oxygen, so you can pick these grapes when they're ready. Not when you need to get rid of the mold.
Oh, interesting. Yeah, yeah. Right. So because it's cool. And I see you made 1,200 bottles this first vintage.
Only 1,200. That's right. They're all numbered.
They're hand numbered.
Right.
And I noticed, because I tasted this a couple days ago, what I noticed was as it changed in the glass, because you point, it's a pretty tight wine, and I think it's from the cool climate. And Malbec, you know, needs some ripening. But, boy, just the 10 minutes we spent together last week, it started to change in the glass rather dramatically.
An hour later, it'll be better.
It's a totally different wine.
Right.
I love the nose, sort of a dried cranberry. There's some fruit there, but
so
it's a little tight.
Usually before breakfast, I never drink.
Oh, wine. Well, I'm sorry. Because your palate is best between 9 and 11 in the morning. That's, that's the deal. Mm-hmm. You know, it's got great mouthfeel. And it's not that overly spicy Malbec. It's got a lot of wonderful tans in the finish, but that mid palate is just going to change. It just it sits here.
Well, Paul, what we set out to do purposely is to not have a novelty wine.
Mm-hmm.
We wanted this to honor Dad. He was a classy guy. We wanted a good wine, and so we did a lot of tasting. We did focus groups, and they made this special blend for me at the winery in Argentina.
So that's he was a wine drinker then.
Oh yes, he was. He used to taste wines and buy wines.
Now, did he care for Hungarian wines?
Oh sure.
Yeah, they have some good
Tokai.
Ones. Yeah, oh yeah, there's some great Tokais. Yeah. I think I told you earlier we have a
Egri Bikkjebjerg.
Oh, Egri, bull's blood.
Bull's blood, right?
Yeah, you don't see that one around much.
No. Maybe I'll import it.
Yeah, you should, because it used to be very popular. We featured some in the club years ago.
If I find a good one, because it really our intent is to go to the famous wine regions of the world and select wine. So we started here in Argentina, starts with an A, but we'll be around to Hungary.
That was you're going to do it alphabetical. Yeah. You go Bulgarian accent. Well, it's great to have you here. If you wouldn't mind autographing this bottle as we wrap this up,
and certainly
what I'm offering to the membership, we have 48 signed bottles from Bela Lugosi Jr. He's going to sign right above his father's signature, and it's going to be first come first serve, and get them while it's hot is what I think. It's a very eerie feeling around here right now. It's kind of, I don't know, maybe the thunder will start or the rain or something.
Sort of hard to sign on a curved bottle, but
it looks good.
It looks pretty good.
There it is, and that's what you'll be getting. It's just a pleasure having you here, Bela, and thank you so much.
Thank you, Paul.
Cheers.